Oh, I don't have any Xbox Live. Fuck! That is just one of the many reasons PCs are better. But the problem is you just can't get a PC that's going to be cheaper than a console that can run GTA 5, right? Wrong! Tonight we're going to show you a PC you can build for less than 150 bucks that's actually going to run GTA 5. Now, best of all, we're actually going to benchmark it. We're not just going to tell you a bunch of parts you've got to buy, because that's just cheating. Now, first off, I had to go and get the game. The first place I went to, the EB in the city, didn't have it. Neither did JB. So, I had to trek it all the way to fucking Darling Harbour, where only there did they have a copy. Isn't Sydney just the city of dreams? Now, if you watch this channel regularly, this is a PC you likely already know well. A PC we're going to take back from vacation just for this video. Oh shit. I forgot to pick him up. Look, I'm sorry I'm late, buddy! Oh, come on, don't be like that! Now, if you don't know this PC, you can watch that video. But basically, it's a Dell that I picked up for about 50 bucks and added a $100 R7 250 to. That ends us on a grand total of 150 bucks. But can it run GTA 5? We will need at least a Intel Core 2 Quad Q6600, which we have, a Radeon 6470 or better, 4 gigs of RAM, not a problem, and of course a 64-bit copy of Windows 7. I think this PC is more than adequate, so let's install the damn game and see how it runs. So how does it run on our $150 PC? Well, as you can see here, the R7 250 is not a 1080p card by any means and is really struggling.
The frame rates mostly stayed around 13 at the worst and 21 at the as an average. The 257 at the max is probably a lie, as the frame rate counter I used probably just caught the intro. But at 720p, the card is reasonably comfortable, and the frame rates are perfectly playable, staying around 36 FPS for most of the time, only dropping to 20 at the worst. But if you are after super high frame rates, you can always just drop that resolution down to 1024x768 and enjoy a smooth 40 FPS for most of the time. Now, these benchmarks are all good, but you're probably wondering how the frame rates go during gameplay, say, for example, in a nice police chase. Well, luckily I have one prepared.
Click clack, blow your bed. Government fingers and tic tac toes in it. And while they're working on the X's and O's, I'm living eye and eye like a Mr. Komozi. No surprise when they're sending foes to me. Opposite are when plain clothes approaching me. Follow the rules is what they propose to me. Selling their souls for what is owed, you see. Nothing is owed, nothing is promised. Never know the government would have run up in a them garrison. Without no sorry, without excuse. Soldier money in a them lorry, everybody.
So there you are, a PC you can get for less than $150. Now, the resolution might not be full HD and the settings might not be at the highest, but it still costs less than a console and the online is gonna be free. If you enjoyed the video, please do like and comment below, and if you like seeing this kind of content, please do subscribe. But before we finish the video, let's jump into the Green Ham mailbox for some fan photos. Our first photos are from a Mr. Ryan McDaniels. And first, we have his setup. It's really quite nice. And I can spot a little CRT in the corner. Lots of approval. As you can see here, he has a nice little rig in an EVGA case with an i7-4790K. Very nice. And there's even a Dell. And like my room, his seems to be filled with PCs. And if you look very closely, you can actually see that they are Athlon PCs. Big thumbs up from me. And in the very corner, he has a G4. Oh, I've got a G4 downstairs. They kick ass. Next up is a lovely little gateway from a YouTube user named Nacho Kins. The gateway is actually not that old, it's a reasonably recent Pentium 4 one. And as you can see, he's added some really nice parts. There's a knock to a fan, a dedicated GPU, and he's actually gutted that gateway and put all of those parts into a really nice Cooler Master case. And as you can see, there's some nice temp gauges on the front. Very nice work, Nacho Kins. Our last fan PC for the day is from a gentleman named Giraj. I hope I pronounced that right, sorry if I'm wrong. It's an old HP tower with a bit of a twist. He's actually painted an awesome Intel logo on the side, along with some really cool little stripes on the top, and as you can see, he's done a little label like I do on my PCs. Totally cool. And the components seem to be reasonably stock, so he's actually kept the machine quite stock, but he's done the case a lot of work. But what I like the most is this. Oh, just look at that. He's gone and done the LEDs somehow so that the vents actually exude this red color. Oh, isn't that just totally cool? Great job, Giraj. Now, if you want to see your PC in this section, make sure to send some pictures, your nickname, and a little bit about it to greenhammailbox@gmail.com. I would love to see the PC, and I'm sure the viewers would as well. So please do send in some pictures. Now, I'm going to leave you with a few shots of myself having slightly too much fun on our GTA 5 PC. Thanks again for watching and enjoy your evening.